National Institute of Standards and Technology, or NIST, also investigated the World Trade Center collapse.
Let me say about the NIST report. My paper and Kevin Ryan's paper addressed the NIST report, and those two papers are available at journalof911studies.com. NIST commissioned Underwriters Laboratories to do an actual experiment test with fire on floor assemblies. These are model floor assemblies now, built just like the World Trade Center floor assemblies. This is the right thing to do. Do an experiment. Underwriters Laboratories built the floor assemblies, put fire in there, more intense actually than what you'd expect in the towers. They beefed up those fires. NIST, to their credit, says, yeah, that's right, the steel does not melt in these towers, but maybe warps enough. So we're looking at the warping here, see. And of course, in these experiments, where they had these extra hot fires for a long time, the steel did not melt, you see, at all. But what you do have is warping. So you've got these long floor assemblies, and the warping in the middle was about 3 inches, not that much, okay, 3 inches warping. But they didn't fail. See? They warped, yeah, 3 inches, but no failure. Kevin Ryan, he was working at Underwriters Laboratories at the time.
My name is Kevin Ryan, and currently a technical services engineer for a healthcare company. I live in Indiana, and I was previously a division manager for Environmental Health Laboratories, a division of Underwriters Laboratories, also in Indiana. I have a degree in chemistry from Indiana University, and I have a certification in quality engineering, which is very closely related to standards and the National Institute of Standards and Technology. I was a laboratory manager at UL for years, so I know about testing samples and national standards. Primarily my involvement, though, is being given information both verbally and in writing about UL's involvement. Also seeing the importance of the issue, and then putting those two things into questions back to my upper management and what we were doing as a company to respond to the official story. But I think to some extent I was fooled by the official story as much as anyone, and I had to admit to myself at one point that I was wrong. That was in 2003. 2 years before that, right after 9/11, is when the chief executive officer of my company, Underwriters Laboratories, had told the staff that UL had tested the steel, had actually certified the steel, he said, used to build the World Trade Center towers, and found out that the steel evidence had been destroyed from the buildings. That related quite directly to the statements made by our chief executive officer that we had tested steel for fire resistance, and yet the steel had been destroyed, which the evidence would have told us what had actually happened. I first sent a formal question to our chief executive officer at Underwriters Laboratories in late 2003, and I laid these concerns out to him. I said, "Look, you told us that we tested the steel or certified the steel. This steel has been destroyed. There's alternative explanations for what happened. You know, the official explanation is something that is, if true, extremely low in probability. So what are we doing? What are you doing to protect our reputation as a company?" And he responded a month later. He did confirm that UL had tested the steel used in the World Trade Center buildings, with quite a number of statements that I have in writing. Clearly, this chief executive officer, who was a Harvard-trained lawyer, by the way, not an engineer, had fully accepted the official story and had been given information himself about testing done 40 years ago by our company to certify the steel in the World Trade Center buildings. And he shared that both verbally and in writing with staff at UL. When he wrote to me, he copied several top executives who all have this in writing right now. And but he asked me to be patient, wait for the report from NIST, because UL was working closely with them to try and figure out what happened, and eventually there would be an explanation. And I did wait for another year, and the report came out. It included a great deal of contradictory information. They had done physical tests both at UL and at NIST, that showed that the steel could not have softened, the floors could not have collapsed. And yet the report was coming out suggesting these things actually did happen. So after a period of about a year, I made a presentation in Chicago where I spelled out the problems with this latest story, official story of collapse, because really the NIST report is one of a string of stories that have been given. A kind of a media story was given, Howard Inferno, a FEMA report was given, it was a pancake story, the Silverstein insurance claim was another story. NIST now has had a couple of stories, but this final story is summarized kind of in seven steps. And if you walk through those and fairly summarize them and look at known facts about the buildings, look at the report within itself, see if it's self-consistent. Just look at the story and see if it's realistic. In all three cases, you can see that it's not, that it's actually false at every one of those seven steps. And that's just a collapse initiation sequence. They don't really describe the actual dynamics of the buildings falling. They actually just say, global collapse ensued. And that way they can ignore a whole lot of evidence that points to an alternative hypothesis, like explosions from witnesses witnessing explosions or hearing it, demolition squibs coming off the buildings, the speed of collapse, which is a very important piece of evidence. They can ignore all of that by just saying global collapse ensues, period. The biggest problems with that story are the fireproofing being lost, and I show in my lecture that the tests that were done, very weak and humble tests done by NIST, proved that actually the fireproofing could not have been lost in the buildings. There was no energy for it. There was no mechanism for it to occur. And probably the biggest problem is the idea that the external columns would bow inward, which is primary to the official story. There is absolutely no physical testing to support that. There is no intuitive reasoning behind it.
Furthermore, in their NIST report, as you read carefully, they only take you to the point where the towers are poised, each tower is poised to collapse. That's their term, poised to collapse. They don't look at what happens after it starts moving. So now then, what does NIST do? They go to a computer simulation, which is not as good as an experiment, you got to admit, right? Because this is now a computer model trying to get an explanation for the buildings to fail. You know, when they got to the warping, instead of 3 inches, which is what the experiment showed, 42 inches, that's over 3 feet of warping. Now, that's a big difference. So you do the experiment, you get 3 inches, like that, and you do your computer model, and you stick in there 42 inches. I mean, what? You see what I'm saying?
And the only support is from a highly manipulated computer model in which, the temperatures were exaggerated, the fire times were exaggerated, all the fireproofing was stripped off, and the floors were disconnected, so that we've got absolutely no actual conceptual framework in which to see columns being pulled inwards. But if the floors are disconnected, there's no force to pull the columns inward. How did it happen? We're talking about a phantom force now in a highly manipulated computer model. And that's what we're basing our future on and all of these changes we're seeing. So they had test results that disproved what they were saying that happened. There were also comments being made still about jet fuel fires and melting steel by experts supporting the official story. So I wrote to NIST and I asked them about their report and I asked them to please clarify the ideas that are being stated in the media and in the report. And I was fired for writing the letter. I was fired for nothing else but writing this letter. I didn't violate any policies. I'd been promoted just earlier that year to the top management position in my division. They gave me a letter of termination. They said that the relationship with NIST was harmed, that it was poor judgment. I was on the front page of my local newspaper, who also interviewed UL. And they asked UL, well, what is this guy saying true? Did you test or certify the steel? And they said, well, there's no evidence that we tested the steel. They didn't say they didn't do it or their CEO was wrong. They said there was no evidence for it. Okay, that's a problem.